As I'm sure I've noted in the past, windows and doors here are supplied by Euroline Windows and Doors out of the Lower Mainland. They are a passive house rated manufacturer of triple glazed windows. And one of the things that I just wanted to particularly note today was when you're buying windows for high performance houses, particularly when you need to comply with STEP code, is pay close attention to your solar heat gain number. These, as you can see from the sticker, are 0.16. That is one of the lowest solar heat gain numbers you can get on a window like this. And this project, as you look out through these windows here, is facing directly south. And so on a house with large windows like this facing south, what you really want to make sure is you're using low solar heat gain windows so that the house does not overheat. I am starting to see designers and energy advisors specify high solar heat gain windows simply to meet the modeling expectation to meet STEP code. And so while you can use a high solar heat gain window to meet your STEP code requirements, it will create a very uncomfortable house. This house does have air conditioning. That's a Mitsubishi head for the Mitsubishi mini split that we have outside. But I can guarantee you, you will not be happy if your air conditioning is running in March. And so that would be the consequence of high solar heat gain windows on a project like this, is that lower sun angle at the end of the day, even on a cold day, would significantly start to overheat this space. So pay attention to your solar heat gain coefficient on your windows and make sure you're using a low number, particularly on your south-facing exposures.